someone who can dance. I'll be right over there by the jukebox, a quarter in my hand, trying to buy myself a chance.
Welcome everybody back to Denver, Colorado, as we make our way up the mountain to Steamboat Springs, Colorado for Music Fest 2019. Hey everybody, it's Justin from the Texas Red Dirt Roads radio show, and a well-planned stop here in Denver at the Grizzly Rose, taking a show by this fella right here, Mr. Randy Rogers. Hello, buddy.
What's up?
How are you?
Sorry I couldn't take you to, you know, Steamboat.
That's all right. We found a very comfortable ride on Wade Bowen's bus, which, by the way, we are sitting in the back of Wade Bowen's bus right now. Wade is not here, and that's about all we're going to say about what's going on Wade's bus.
We've already tried on all of his clothing.
Right. Somebody needs to clean this place up.
Took a shower.
Right. So, bus, while we're talking about buses, is bus life all that everybody thinks it's cracked up to be? Because that's one part of the experience the fan never gets. It's like, ooh, the bus, that's cool. What's it like when the show's over with and everybody climbs on?
It's everything it's cracked up to be.
Mm-hmm.
If you are touring in a van right now.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you're in a van, of course you want the bus.
In our case, it was an 88 Suburban.
Mm-hmm.
When we started, so.
Right.
So it's absolutely worth it.
100%. Yes. But, I mean, is it the big keg parties, disco balls, loud music going on all the time?
Every night.
Every night. Is it really?
Front lounge. We actually do have disco lights in our front lounge.
Right.
So, no.
So the party goes on. See, so it is something that everybody.
It is like.
It is. It's just like you imagined it.
Every eighth grade guitar player's dream. On our bus. Every night.
Right. How was your? How would you say your 2018 was? Looking back on it now.
It was busy. It was a little bit. We didn't have a record, so we didn't have something to promote.
But you were working on a record.
It was creative.
Right.
Yeah. So we were working on the Stryker Brothers record, which we didn't tell anybody about, but record with myself and Robert Earl Keen,
mm-hmm.
as well as Randy Rogers Band record, which drops April 26th. By the way.
Right.
So it was a creative year. But we toured. I mean, we played 140 shows.
Mm-hmm.
So we stayed out there.
Right. April 26th, new record. Do we have a title?
We do.
You going to tell me?
No.
Come on, man. Come on. Years and years of friendship. Just
hey,
washed
on.
Down the drain. All right, we'll wait. We'll wait till April 24th.
Yeah, you know, it's like I don't really know yet. I mean, it's
right.
The artwork is kind of there.
How many tracks are we talking? Songs?
12, I think.
12 songs.
Yeah. I wrote a bunch of songs with Sean McConnell again.
Right.
Which has seemed through the years to be kind of like my wheelhouse.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a country record too, and
right.
There's some Texas flair to it. There's some rock and roll to it. There's some there's more guitars maybe this time around,
mm-hmm.
than Nothing Shines Like Neon, where Neon was more pedal steel and kind of twangy stuff. You know, like. I don't know. It's more of what we sounded like without any other studio musicians and no help.
Right.
It's just the band in mm-hmm. the studio banging these songs out. So.
April 26th, new Randy Rogers record.
Named. I love Justin Frazell.
You heard it here first. Anything else is a bogus copy. If your copy does not say that. Bought it off the
black one that
market.
We're going to send to you says that.
It does. I bet it does. Yeah. I bet it does. Man, now looking into 2019, not to get too far ahead, but let's start with Music Fest. This has always got to be a fun and exciting way to kick off every year.
I think it's my 17th.
Right?
16th or 17th
mm-hmm.
Music Fest. So. It is. It's different now.
Is it as much, because I hear this all the time, that as much as it is for the fans to come up and see all of you guys and girls play over a 4 to 5 day period and experience a festival like none other. Dixon and his team put on a phenomenal festival. It's just as much as a reunion for your side of the stage. You get to see a lot of your artist buddies that you don't ever get to see because you're usually crisscrossing the highways. So,
yeah, in a lot of different interesting ways I get to see them.
Yeah? Like?
You know.
Besides
flying,
walking in a bathrobe down the hall of the Grand?
Yeah, flying down a mountain and... Right. Flying really high in the evenings, you know, and
sure.
Jamming and playing music and running around making food for everybody. It's funny, everybody cooks.
Yeah.
So it's like everywhere you go.
It's like a potluck there at the hotel.
Somebody's like, oh, you got to come try so-and-so's chili or whatever. So.
Right. do you take advantage of it as in more than just an opportunity to sit down and have dinner? I mean, do you get into a creative process? Would you like find somebody you wouldn't usually see and go, hey, let's go try to write a song, or let me help you with something, or maybe you come help me with something?
I have some really bad recordings on my phone of like half songs.
Of projects you thought were going to be available?
Yeah. I did meet my wife in Steamboat, so
right.
That's a big right. positive. She's already there, by the way.
So right.
With the kids.
Waiting on you to do your program here.
Yeah, so I'm excited about it. It is nice to see everybody, and, you know, I think Steamboat more than anything, Music Fest, it is the, still, it's the event of the year
right.
for guys like us and girls like us
mm-hmm.
that write songs. And I mean, the year that I came here the first time, I was in a van. I can't remember exactly the time slot we played, but it was
right.
opening for
Sun was up.
Corey Morrow or someone. And, you know, I remember those times, and they were like great memories that I have of,
sure.
of playing this festival.
Since you're talking about how long you've been around, you've become quite the mentor to some of those that
have they told you that?
That are keeping the train rolling in this Texas, you know, red dirt music scene. And I know you've got kind of your hand on the back of Red Shahan, Parker McCollum. So
right.
tell me why those guys?
Well, you see something in somebody and you
yeah.
go, well, you got it. Whatever it is,
mm-hmm.
you know, you can't really put it on paper. You can't define it. You just know that it's there.
Yeah.
That's the way I feel about it, and both those guys have it. So we have a management company, my partner Robin Sheff and I started
mm-hmm.
called Big Blind Management, and, you know, what we do is try to, like, guide people.
Yeah.
Let them make their own decisions. At the same time, I've been down a lot of paths through record deals, publishing deals,
mm-hmm.
Contractual agreements with different promoters, and all in all, I don't think there's much hadn't seen, so.
Right.
That's what I have to offer. So I thought, you know, why don't we take some of these folks and say, look, here are the pitfalls. Here are the good people like
mm-hmm.
you.
Thank you.
To work with and do things with. And then here are the people that are just blowing smoke. So,
sure.
I think it saved people money. I think it saved people a lot of headaches. And, you know, obviously both Red and Parker's careers have been 2018 was great for both them, so
mm-hmm.
you know, I think if we can continue that and that growth, and you know, my focus is always on the songwriting,
right?
Taking time out, spending time with yourself to write, making all about the song, making all about the product, and kind of preaching that as a ritual.
Mm-hmm.
I think is good for a young songwriter. So
true. Well, I mean, to sit it, you know, I'm gonna kind of kiss you on the cheek here, but. A great opportunity for those guys, or girls, whoever you take under your management wing, to kind of sit at your feet, because in the time that you've been running these highways, from your suburban days to now on borrowing Wade's bus, although yours is just right outside.
Ours is disco lights and parking.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
You've got a lot of knowledge that you can share with those guys, so that's a golden opportunity to have, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's not much that I haven't seen, and it's like, people think it's overnight, you know, people think, well, like even, you know, Parker's success of late, people think, well, it just came from nowhere. No way. We've been working Parker for 3 years.
Yeah.
It takes time.
It does. I remember the first time he came into the studio with me and was bringing the Limestone Kid record in, and he was really genuine. He was very polite. He was very eager. He was very appreciative, and I don't see that has changed in him at all. Even with the amount of success that he's seen. And Red Shahan, you know, I knew him right about the time that he joined Six Market Boulevard. That's when I first met him for that brief stint.
Yeah,
but
they were great.
He just seems like he's just a good old boy, just got some songs he wants everybody to see. And I just got back from Las Vegas covering some events for the National Finals Rodeo. And it was really cool to see Red Shahan's name right underneath Dwight Yoakam. That's who he opened for in Las Vegas. I was like, now that's how you punch a hole in something right there.
Yeah, I preach be excellent and be gone.
Yeah.
Like, from tour manager, from management to artist, it's like from contract to curtain,
mm-hmm.
you do your job, you say thank you,
right.
and you go do it the next night.
Right.
You know, you don't complain, you don't argue, you don't fight, you don't be a prima donna, you just to your show, do it again, right. again, and again, and again.
As many as you can get.
And eventually you'll get good at it. I think, you know, this is 18 years of being on the road as Randy Rogers' band, so if you just average 120, 125 shows a year for those 18 years, I mean, that's a bunch.
That is a bunch.
So,
you know, can you believe you're doing it? Is this, I mean, to
it's
you?
It's still fun. I mean,
to
like,
you, do you have to kind of close your eyes a little bit? And
we're playing sold out Grizzly Rose tonight, and you know, it's funny because Parker, I think he got live at Cheatham Street when he was 12 or something. So. Yeah. And he always says to me, it's good that you're still relevant. And I'm like, I don't know whether to hit you or, like, take that as a compliment. You know?
Yeah, well, it's a big compliment. It really is.
But selling out Grizzly Rose is fun, and playing Red Rocks here, obviously, is amazing. And, you know, same guys in the band for all these years. Yep. I mean, it's
same team
fun.
Forever, man. It's fantastic.
Like, making records now, I think, is probably going to be the focus over the next decade, so... Just churning music out.
And not that you got bored with it, but you certainly started to dip your toe into some other ventures here recently when you purchased Cheatham Street. I know you've got something with the Cleveland Railroaders. I don't know how big a piece of pie that is, but I know your name is associated with that team, the Independent Baseball League there in Cleveland, Texas. You've got the new Chop House in Roanoke. What am I? You got the, obviously.
Chop Shop Live.
Right. Sorry, yeah. In Roanoke, Texas, and then obviously you got your management company. So is that something that you're, I don't want to say shifting to, but is that something you're going to try to take more of? Like, do you have something in 2019? You're like, okay, now I want to go get a piece of that.
I just always enjoyed the business side of music.
Yeah.
And so if you relisted all those things, they all have something to do with music in a way. And so I was always the guy that booked the band under an assumed name before we got an agent. I was always the guy, and still am the guy, on the way to the airport today. I had a conversation with the promoter about how to do a show in Houston next year, and thinking about porta-potties, all the way from porta-potties to, you know, who's going to be the key sponsor of the event. So, I don't know, I just think that, like, that excites me as much as finishing a song and sending it to you to listen to, or whatever, you know? It's like, I enjoy work, I enjoy being a busy bee, my wife says to me that, like, I might not be the most talented, but I'm tenacious. I think that's right. Hilarious. I just go get it. Like, if I come up with an idea, if I want to put on a 4th of July show next year, wherever, like, I put all my, you know, assets and my ability and my contacts and everything that I have into that event.
Yeah.
Like, and it's true, some of them fail. And I think that's key to young people listening to this. It's like, it's okay to fail. It's okay to have your aspirations, your dreams, your, you know, ambitions not come to fruition, because it just makes you stronger. It makes you smarter. It makes you do better the next time.
And if so, you learn from it.
Sure.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. I mean, yeah, fail. Failure's part of it, but learn from those failures.
Yeah, I've never really had I've never had an opportunity that I passed up.
Sure.
I don't have any regrets when it comes to my business in that sense. Because Guy Clark said it, you know, trust your cape.
Yeah.
Jump. You know, I've always had that mentality in business. And so when you see in the news, or you see people write stories or blogs about me starting this or me doing this, it's just me trying to do everything that I can do to, you know, further... this industry.
I'm a fan of that theory. I tell people all the time that even if it's an idea that's come to you that came out of left field, always take the meeting, because you don't know where it's going to lead to. Just because you take the meeting doesn't mean that you're going to agree to do something. But be there to listen, because you're either going to appreciate and dive into that idea, or it may spark something in your own mind that you can take from it. But yeah, you're right. Like you say, you know, take the opportunities and do that. I'm like, I'm the same way. Take the meeting.
Yeah, and so back to that kind of thought process, and like Randy Rogers is an entrepreneur. I also want to say, like, I had a great time making this record. I wrote 50 songs in 2 years for this project.
Yeah.
On top of the songs I was writing for the Stryker Brothers project, as well as the new record that Wade and I are going to make in February, Hold My Beer Volume 2.
Right.
So there's also this creative thing that really churns mm-hmm. everything else that comes out of the band and the records and the singles and the things that, you know, really we're passionate about. Mm-hmm. Everything else is just like a spoke on the wheel
yeah.
of all this. So I just hope that, like, people can understand the difference between the entrepreneurship or the trying to expand and broaden my horizons, mm-hmm. you know, and then pause for a minute and just think that I wrote 50 songs for this record.
Right.
And continue on writing, you know, next week with Wade for our project. So mm-hmm. it's like this constant evolving of a human mm-hmm. and your mind and your psyche and your creativity becoming this whole thing. And, you know, I mean, look at Jimmy Buffett. I mean, look at these guys that, look at Kiss. These bands that have, you know, breached the borders of a genre and became these, you know, global, you know,
entities. Yeah, I mean, they're, yeah, exactly. That's the word I was going to use, entity.
Yeah, and I think our scene in general is as vibrant as it's ever been. There's so much young talent. Mm-hmm. There's so many young singer-songwriters, male and female, doing this, selling tickets, selling t-shirts. And I think that, like, it's time to have leaders. It's time for guys like me and for guys like Wade and several others to be like, you know what, let me show you. Mm-hmm. Like, this is how you get a record deal. This is how you get a publishing deal. And then that doesn't matter. What really matters is the song and writing that song mm-hmm. and singing that song and performing to the best of your ability and then doing it the next night.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, that's what sells the tickets.
Yeah.
I mean, your tickets aren't sold on the basis, like, oh, well, he's got a publishing deal and a record deal, so we should go see this guy. No. People are lined up at the door right now because they can't wait to hear the 17 or 18
songs. Well, they want to drink and dance.
Well, there's that, but they don't want to drink and I bet as many people wouldn't be in that bar tonight if your name wasn't on the marquee.
Well, thank you.
Well, you know it. Thank you for always hanging out with me, man. And with all your successes, you always make time for me, and I always appreciate that, man. It means the world to me.
Yeah, man.
And April 26th, look for that new Randy Rogers Band record. We love Justin Frazell, right?
In our pants.
In the back of Wade's bus. By the way, thank you, Wade, for letting us use the bus. So there's a whole lot with Randy Rogers. Appreciate you guys watching. Appreciate you tuning in. And we're going to head inside the Grizzly Rose. Try to bring you some of the show tonight, as much as Randy will allow, of course. And then we'll see you on the mountain tomorrow in Steamboat Springs, Colorado, for Music Fest 2019. Make sure you visit randyrogersband.com. Circle that date, April 26th, and make sure to keep up with all the content that we're going to have for you this week, txrdr.com, and all of our social networks that launch from TXRDR. Thanks again to Jag Metals and Colorado High Vodka and our friends at the Finolio Boot Company. See you on the mountain. See you down the road.
See you down the road. Ah!